Let us discuss about law of reciprocal proportion. This law states that the ratio of two elements x and y, which combine separately with a fixed weight of third element, let's say z, should be always a simple multiple ratio by their weights. Means what? See, x is combining with z, y is also combining with z. It is forming two different compounds. Then the ratio of these two, x and y, which are combining with z, must be, the weights must be in a simple whole number ratio. Let us discuss with some examples. First one, sulfur can combine with hydrogen, sulfur can combine with oxygen. Okay, so sulfur can combine with hydrogen and forms H2S. Sulfur can combine with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide. Okay, now we can guess what is the third compound, how the weights of hydrogen and oxygen that they form, and they will combine together and forms a compound. Let's see, sulfur, hydrogen and oxygen, there are three elements x, y, z. Sulfur and oxygen are combining, they are forming sulfur dioxide. Sulfur and hydrogen is combining, they are forming H2S. Then oxygen and hydrogen, how they used to combine according to law of reciprocal proportion? These two, x and y, both commonly combining with z, that is S. So these two should combine in a fixed whole number ratio to form the molecule. Now let's see how it is possible. So we know it forms H2O. You can calculate now. In SO2, the ratio of their molecular weights is sulfur 32. In SO2, if you see, sulfur 32 and oxygen 32. Two atoms we have, 60 times 2 is 32. Similarly, in H2S, if I say, okay, sulfur is 32 and hydrogens, 2 are there, 2 times 1, 2. Now, oxygen and hydrogen, how to combine? Because they are combining with the fixed weights. So, they have to, hydrogen and oxygen ratio must be 2 is to 32. You can simplify that. 1 is to 16. So, or it may be a multiple of this. Example, if you take H2O, in H2O molecule, hydrogen atomic mass is 2 and oxygen is 16. If you simplify this, it is combining it 1 is to 8. You can see they are the simple whole number ratio. So, this is the way we can predict the third type of molecule that we may get from X and Y. Let me explain with one more example, that is sodium can combine with chlorine and sodium can combine with hydrogen. When you say these two are X and Y, they are combining commonly with Z, that is sodium. Then you have to know that whenever these two want to combine X and Y, they should be in a fixed whole number ratio. They used to combine in a fixed whole number ratio. Now let's take correlation, sodium, chlorine, hydrogen. Sodium and chlorine will combine, form sodium chloride. Sodium and hydrogen combines and forms sodium hydride. And hydrogen and chlorine will combine and forms HCl. So how we got this? Let's see, it should be in fixed whole number ratio. In NaCl, if you see the molecular weight ratios of sodium and chlorine, 23 is to 35. And in sodium hydride, 23 is to 1. So how these hydrogen and chlorine should combine now? Because these are equal. So they have to form in this whole number ratio or multiple of this. So HCl should combine in the form of 1 is to 35. So it's same as it is. Hydrogen 1, chlorine 34. So it can combine this way. You can predict what is the compound that will be formed by X and Y. Similarly, we can take many examples to explain this concept. I'm going to take one more example, that is copper can combine with oxygen, copper can combine with sulfur. In what way it will combine? Let's see. Copper, oxygen, sulfur. CuO, CuS. So you can predict how these two should undergo according to law of reciprocal proportion. Let's see in CuO what are their molecular weight ratios. Atomic masses 63.5 and 60. Similarly in CuS 63.5 and sulfur is 32. How sulfur and oxygen will combine now? 32, 16. So are in a simple whole number ratio. So that's the reason why sulfur and oxygen can combine and use sulfur dioxide. You can calculate 32, 32. So they are combining in 1:1 ratio. So it is a multiple of this one. So in this way, by using this law, we can predict how X and Y combines and forms molecule. They have to combine in a simple whole number ratio of their weights. That's all about law of reciprocal proportion. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.